हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू ईसे एकेडमी।
इन दिस लेक्चर लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड द प्रॉब्लम्स ऑन इनवर्स जेड ट्रांसफॉर्म यूजिंग पार्शियल फ्रैक्शन मेथड। लेट अस टेक द फर्स्ट प्रॉब्लम वेयर एक्स ऑफ जेड इज गिवन एज 1 माइनस 2 जेड इनवर्स प्लस 3 जेड टू द पावर ऑफ माइनस 2 प्लस 4 जेड टू द पावर ऑफ माइनस 3 विथ ROC फॉर ऑल द वैल्यूज ऑफ Z. So for this type of problem where they have given a sequence, we need not use partial fraction method. So these are the problems which can be solved directly using inverse Z transform. If we apply inverse Z transform, X of Z can be written as X of N. That can be written as 1 can be written in the form of delta. We can write delta of N minus 2. Z inverse, we can write it as delta of n minus 1 plus 3. Z to the power of minus 2, we can write it as delta of n minus 2 plus 4. Z to the power of minus 3, we can write it as delta of n minus 3. So we can write x of n is equal to, for delta, we can write it as 1. For minus 2, delta of n minus 1, we can write that as minus 2. Then we can write plus 3 and plus 4. So this is the sequence for x of n. Since delta of n will be at the origin, so we can write 1 will be at origin. So we can write the arrow mark. Now let us consider the second problem, where x of z is equal to z square divided by z minus 1. Into z minus 1 by 2. Here ROC is magnitude of z greater than 1. So this type of problem we need to solve using partial fraction method. Now while using the partial fraction method, always remember the power in the numerator should be less than the power in the denominator. So if you observe here, the power in the numerator is same as the power in the denominator. If you multiply this z with z, you will get z square. So both the powers are same. So always remember, the power in numerator should not be greater than or equal to the denominator power. So that's why we need to make sure that the power in the numerator is less than the power in the denominator. So that's why we'll divide LHS as well as RHS with Z. So this procedure you need to follow for all the problems when you are solving using partial fraction method. So if we divide with z, we'll get x of z divided by z will be equal to z divided by z minus 1 into z minus 1 by 2. We can write that as z divided by z minus 1 into z minus 1 by 2 is equal to, using partial fraction method procedure, we can write this as a divided by z minus 1 plus b divided by z minus 1 by 2. So if you multiply this denominator part, at that case we will get z is equal to a into z minus 1 by 2 plus b into z minus 1. Let us consider this as equation number 1. Now in equation number 1, if we put z is equal to 1. So if you put z is equal to 1, b term in equation number 1 will become 0. So we will get 1 is equal to a by 2. So from this we can say a is equal to 2. Similarly, in equation number 1, if you put z is equal to 1 by 2, at that case a term will become 0 in equation number 1, then we will get 1 by 2 is equal to minus b by 2. From this we can say b is equal to minus 1. So we got the value of a as well as b. Let us substitute the value of a and b in this equation. Therefore we can write z divided by z minus 1 into z minus 1 by 2 will be equal to 2 divided by z minus 1 minus 1 divided by z minus 1 by 2. So this term is nothing but x of z divided by z from this equation. So in place of LHS we can write x of z divided by z is equal to 2 divided by z minus 1 minus 1 by z minus 1 by 2. So this equation we can write it as x of z is equal to 2z divided by z minus 1 minus z divided by z minus 1 by 2. So what we have done?
We have multiplied this z towards RHS and we got this expression.
So for this expression we need to take inverse z transform. We know from the basic formula of z transform which we understood from our previous video, we can write z divided by z minus a, we can write it as a to the power of n u of n. Now we can use this to find the inverse z transform. So finally we can write x of z as x of n, that can be written as, so if we take 2 common in this expression, so we can write 2 in place of a, we are having 1 here, so that's why 1 to the power of n u of n minus z divided by z minus 1 by 2 in place of n, we are having 1 by 2 here, so that's why we can write 1 by 2 whole to the power of n u of n. So 1 to the power of n we can write it as 1 itself, therefore finally we can write x of n is equal to 2 u of n minus 1 by 2 whole to the power of n u of n. So this is the inverse z transform for the given problem using partial fraction method. Let us take the third problem where x of z is given as minus 1 plus 5 z inverse divided by 1 minus 3 by 2 z inverse plus 1 by 2 z to the power of minus 2. So here the z power is in terms of negative values. So let us make this power of z in terms of positive values. So what we need to do, let us multiply numerator and denominator with z square. So if you multiply numerator and denominator with z square, we can write x of z is equal to minus z square plus 5z divided by z square minus 3 by 2z plus 1 by 2. Now in the numerator, if we take z as common, so at that case we will get 5 minus z divided by, for the denominator part, if you find the roots of this equation, so we will get minus 1 by 2 and minus 1. If we use these two roots, we can write the denominator as z minus 1 into z minus 1 by 2. So again, we can write x of z divided by z is equal to 5 minus z divided by z minus 1 into z minus 1 by 2. Let us call this as equation number 1. So let us take 5 minus z divided by z minus 1 into z minus 1 by 2. Let us use partial fraction method. We can write that as a divided by z minus 1 plus b divided by z minus 1 by 2. So let us multiply this denominator part. So we will get 5 minus z is equal to a into z minus 1 by 2 plus b into z minus 1. So let us take this as equation number 2. In this equation, equation number 2, if we put z is equal to 1 by 2, at that case the term a will be equal to 0. So we will get 4.5 is equal to minus b by 2. So from this we can say b is equal to minus 9. In the same way, in equation number 2, if we take z is equal to 1, at that case the term b will be equal to 0 in equation number 2. So we will get 4 is equal to a by 2. So from this we can say a is equal to 8. So we got the values of a and b. So we need to substitute these values in this equation. So we need to substitute in this equation. So we can write 5 minus z divided by z minus 1 into z minus 1 by 2 is equal to 8 divided by z minus 1 minus 9 divided by z minus 1 by 2. We know this term, we can write it as x of z divided by z from equation number 1. So x of z divided by z is equal to 8 by z minus 1 minus 9 divided by z minus 1 by 2. Therefore, we can write x of z is equal to 8z divided by z minus 1 minus 9z divided by z minus 1 by 2. So again, we can use the general formula of inverse z transform, where we can write z divided by z minus a as a to the power of n u of n. So using this formula, we can write the above expression as x of n is equal to, let us take 8, so z divided by z minus 1. So here in place of a we are having 1, so we can write 1 to the power of n u of n minus 9 z divided by z minus 1 by 2. In place of a we are having 1 by 2, so we can write 1 by 2 whole to the power of n u of n. So finally we can write x of n is equal to 8, 1 to the power of n is 1 itself, so we can write 8 into u of n minus 9 into 1 by 2 whole to the power of n u of n. So this is the final expression for the inverse z transform of the given problem. So these are the problems about inverse z transform using partial fraction method. I hope you have understood the topic. Thank you.